Thankfully, our auditorium is finally being renovated. It's been long overdue. It happened sooner than we anticipated last week. So that is why we're out here. But thankfully, due to some construction mishap, they actually created quite a nice place to sing. So we're kind of thankful that we've got this wonderful space and that we were able to bring in enough chairs. A couple things off the bat. As you can tell, this room's a bit rainy. So as talking happens, it tends to rain. The purpose of tonight is, of course, the music. So I hope that you will allow yourself to enjoy the music while keeping the chatter down while the students are performing. Feel free to chatter all you would like in between and applaud however you desire. That would be wonderful. If we could also do this wonderful thing, because electronics don't work well out here either, if you could go ahead and take your lovely phones out, make sure that that little side button is just clicked. Right, that lovely little side button that says it's not going to be an annoyance to anybody around you. And it's okay, check it, because I can get it 34, and you know, most of us are at that age where we just have to remind ourselves, how's this thing work? So if you could go ahead and make sure yours is on silent, or just turn it off, we'll be okay with that as well. If you like the video, please do so. Avoid standing the video, right? Because there are other people around you that would also like to see their students perform. The restrooms are over there, and I will find somebody who will kindly open the men's restroom from the gate. High schoolers can't be trusted, but I think all of you can, so we'll definitely get the men's restroom open. As soon as you graduate, you just become free labor, so. Yeah, you could have done it. So tonight we will be opening with two special choirs, our men's choir and our women's choir. These two choirs used to exist, but you know how COVID just changed everything. We kind of lost numbers and it kind of fell by the wayside. So we decided to bring back men's and women's choir. These men and women meet outside of normal hours. They meet every other week. So we will be performing with music tonight. We're not a memorized group, but the purpose for these guys coming to sing is purely enjoyment and to sing together with other men or sing together with other women. So tonight we present for you Shenandoah and Take This Honey by the Warren Central High School Men's Choir.
Thank you.
Our students are generally not involved in sports activities, because they have after school band, they have after school or cheer or dance or, so these are our few who we give them something else to do. And it really is a great opportunity. All of our choirs sing multi-part music, male and female, so the opportunity for men to get to sing with men only enhances their abilities individually by singing together and enforcing and encouraging other manly sounds. The same true for our women's choir. Though they be small, they be beautiful, right? They definitely are. Okay, that's okay. Parents, love their children, right? That's okay. So our women's choir also meets every other Thursday. And we're hoping to continue to grow this. Everyone starts off smaller, and then we grow. So they will be producing. They will be singing for you tonight, Rise Above and Firefly.
Thank you.
our men's and women's choir. Now we get into the part of tonight where it features every single choir that we do. So we'll start with Total Sound. Total Sound is formerly a show choir. We're no longer a show choir. Now we're an acapella group. And the good news is, we're more forward. We're much better as an acapella group than we ever could have been as a show choir. So I highly encourage you to tell all your kids when you hear this group, stay in choir. Come be a member of Total Sound. And also Madrigal, right? So they're going to be singing a jazz arrangement for you tonight. It's tough. These kids have never even heard this music before because they weren't even conceived, thought of, or even believed at this point. Some of you probably weren't even alive when this song was written. So it's a good way to expose them to a type of music that is often forgotten. It's tough, and they sing it dang good. Total Sound will be performing at Acapfest in November, which is the state's largest acapella competition. And then in the spring, they will also go to USM and perform at Spirit of Southern Invitational. Belt because it hasn't yet taken off strong enough for show choir to disappear. So tonight they will be performing for you all the things you are from a very warm, it's from something. The soloist tonight will be Jana Park. Choirs in the state of Mississippi. assess their individual abilities. Any choir can be force-fed music. Any choir can replicate sound they hear. No single individual can be, you just can't cheat on sight reading. You either do it or you don't. So Magical is currently working on level 7 right now across 3 different styles. So we have our regular sight reading, we have our minor sight reading, and we have our compound time sight reading. It is my pleasure to say that of most of the schools in the state of Mississippi, we are the only school that actively encourages every choir to read in both the major and the minor, as well as teaching them compound time as well as regular time. It is our desire that no matter what level your kid is at, that they be able to graduate from Warren Central High School or RCC as a member of the Warren Central Choral Department and obtain the highest level of scholarship money available to whichever college they desire to go to. We have shown it in the past, and we will continue to show it forward by teaching them to sight read. So Magicals reads at level 7. They will finish out the year at a level 8. The next choir that we have for us is the Varsity Choir. Varsity is currently our largest ensemble, and always should be. It is comprised of kids that have already graduated out of our concert choir or have entered in by audition from AOI or Warren Junior. They are currently reading at a level 5. For any of you who attended our concert last year, I would remind you that Varsity Choir at our fall concert was reading at a level 3. And when we say reading, we actually lied. We had just started. So for this year, for us to be reading at a level 5 and not lying is a major improvement. That tells us that the work that we're doing constantly is benefiting your kids and the music that they will be capable of doing both now and forever will ever be just better because of what they can do. So tonight they will produce, again with the producers, they're going to sing 3 songs for you, Non Nobis Domine, Vox Vibe, and Justice, On Justice, Truth, and Peace.
Bye.
long way. We continue to see great things for Varsity. It will continue to be one of our largest suppliers as we continue to recruit. Again, if you've got younger siblings, get them inquired. They can do everything. Have them do sports, have them do cheer, have them do dance, have them do choir, because it's all going to pay for college and it'll save you lots of money. And choir gets the single most amount of money than any other activity that a college campus ever. And it's the easiest thing to do for a scholarship. But I'm not here to convince you to get your kids in choir. Except you should. So the next choir that we have up is our concert choir. Concert choir is a group that we brought back. In my first year here, I actively recruited kids in the hallway and said, are you not in choir? And shoved them in the class. And we started having a concert choir again. And it has always served a purpose for anybody who seeks to want to be part of the choir. If you like to sing, if you sing in the shower, if you sing in the car, wherever you like to sing, come be part of choir and we get you into concert choir. So this is probably, if I'm honest, one of my favorite times of the day is to get to work with these kids in concert choir. Generally, mornings are always glum, but this group of concert choir kids actually makes it fun to come to work besides being able to drink that cup of coffee to get the day going. We are currently reading at a level 3. And we read extensively. Again, most of these kids came from either I was in choir, or I just like to sing, or Martasia just happened to be at the wrong place at the wrong time, and her name got on the board, and then she ended up in choir. But that's okay, because we love Martasia. So they're going to be performing for you two pieces tonight, Beyond the Silver Mountain and Bona Ha.
Thank you. The two pieces that we'll be singing tonight are Antiphonal Cantate, which is Sing a Song, and The Cuckoo. And we hope you enjoy. Thank you.
the top audition ensemble that we have here. They read the highest, they also have to do the most. So they are often put into after-school rehearsals. They sing anytime somebody says, hey, we need a choir. December is a big month for us. We'll be performing across the city. We've got two churches lined up. We've got a Christmas Eve service lined up. We've got an Episcopal tour lined up. We've got something in Jackson also lined up. So when this choir auditions, they know that they're about to put the work through. So tonight they will be performing three pieces for you: Omnes Gentes, Sanctus, and Lux Aeterna. Don't mean it.
Thank you.
coming out tonight for our very first concert happening in the Fjord. You've been the best audience we've ever had. That's your last joke for tonight. Might as well laugh at it. Don't get better.